making a graph. Bar chart is a kind of graph. Here we show the data, which shows the number of the over and the runs scored in that over. On the y axis, we plot runs. On the x axis, we plot over. And here is the score in the first over, in the second over, in the third over, the score is 0. In the fourth over, the score is 10. In the fifth over, the score is 2. And in the sixth over, score is 5. So, this is a bar chart. Pie chart is another kind of graph. This pie chart shows the composition of air. Nitrogen is 78%, oxygen is 21%, and others just 1%. Here is what we call a line graph, in which there are lines representing the data. Again, on the y axis, we have number of runs, and on the x axis, we have overs, and the data shows the rate at which two teams are scoring. Here is another example of a line graph. This graph shows the height of male and female children at various ages. Notice that the inference that you can draw by just looking at this graph may not be so easily drawn from the data itself. That is the advantage of a graphical representation. For example, by just looking at the graph, we can say that at age 13, girls tend to be taller than boys. At age 18 and above, boys tend to be taller than the girls. Now, we are ready to draw a graph. We choose the area of the graph. Since all values are positive, therefore, we choose this area for drawing the graph. This is a sample of a graph paper. This is how we represent data. In this column, we have got time. In this column, we have got distance. Here, in this row, we have time, and in this row, we have distance. It doesn't matter whichever way you prefer, you can represent the data. Here is the animation that shows how we plot the various points. You remember, the first point is 0 time and 0 distance. So, 0 minute, 0 kilometer, and this is the point. The second point, remember, was 1 kilometer, 1 minute. So, from 1 kilometer, we draw a line. And then, from 1 minute, we draw a line. Wherever these two lines meet, we have 1 kilometer, 1 minute. This is the point. Similarly, for the second point, we have 2 kilometers and 2 minutes. So, we draw a line at 2 kilometers. We draw a line at 2 minutes. Wherever the two lines intersect, we have the point 2 minute 2 kilometers, and this is the point. Similarly, we plot this 3 minute 3 kilometer point, 4 minute 4 kilometer point, 5 minute 5 kilometer point, and then we have to join all these points by a line, and this is your graph representing the data that we had. This is called distance time graph, because on the y axis we have distance, on the x axis we have time. Now, let us see from this graph where was the bus at time 3.6 minutes, that is 3 minutes 36 seconds. To find this, we draw a vertical line at 3.6 minutes. This is the vertical line. At the point of intersection with the graph, at this point, draw the horizontal line and read the distance on the y-axis. What was the time when the bus was at a distance of 2.5 kilometers? To find this, draw a horizontal line at 2.5 kilometers. This is the line. At the point of intersection of this line with the graph, draw a vertical line and read the distance on the x-axis. You can read 2.5 minutes. So, when the bus was at 2.5 kilometers, the time elapsed was 2.5 minutes. This is called interpolation, and this is the way a graph is interpreted.